Jesse Smollett.
You know what it is? It's Empire Wednesday! The season premieres tonight.
I've heard of that show.
Yeah, a couple times.
Are you excited?
I'm excited.
I'm excited.
I haven't seen it yet.
You don't get to see in advance?
I do, but I don't want to. I want to see it with the people. You know what I'm saying? I saw the first four minutes, man, it's heavy. But we find out who, you know. So, first 4 minutes, you don't want to miss it. You don't want to miss it.
And then I'm so excited.
I'll be live tweeting tonight like crazy.
Oh, okay. So is that part of it? You live tweet?
I mean, it's not like a contractual obligation.
No, but people are very engaged in that right now.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
That's like all part of.
I think that kind of started with like Scandal, you know, because they really were so great at social media. I think that we all kind of took a clue from them.
Yeah. We started live tweeting here about 7 years after Twitter started.
Mm-hmm.
And by live tweeting, I mean, we would tweet something that happened on the live show about 3.5 weeks later.
Sometimes it happens.
Yeah, we're at the tail end of social media, but we're getting there.
We're getting there.
We're working on it. Every day there's fresh hope. Every day there's fresh hope.
We could do it, y'all.
So is there something else going on in your life?
There is. There is a big announcement today. November 25th of this year. I'm nervous to even say it out loud.
Guys, just sit on your hands for a second.
November 25th of this year, one night only, I will be opening in Hawaii with the great Mariah Carey. Tickets go on sale this Saturday, so come one, come all.
Guys, it's so easy to get to from here.
Just go chill in LA.
But you said you've never been to Hawaii.
I've never been to Hawaii.
We've done the show in Hawaii.
See?
It is.
You should come and do the show in Hawaii during Thanksgiving.
Done and done. Did you hear the good news, Gelman? We're doing the show in Hawaii. Thanksgiving,
nice.
And we're going to live broadcast and tweet Jesse opening for Mariah.
That's right.
Right. Wow.
That's right. The Sweet Sweet Fantasy Tour is coming to Hawaii. Yeah.
So it's exciting.
It's my first time being on a tour. It's my first time opening for anybody. So it's the great Mariah Carey. So don't get better than that.
I'm jittery. I'm so excited.
I'm jittery because I'm nervous.
I mean, I'm jittery and I'm nervous and I'm excited. And you've never been to Hawaii and it's so gorgeous. I'm afraid you may not come back. They may have to move Empire to Hawaii.
Oh my God. You know what? We don't travel enough on Empire.
No.
We don't. That's
you
actually
don't.
Very true. We'll make it happen.
Cookie goes to Hawaii.
So how was your night?
I had a great night. I went to my friend John and Lizzie Tisch's house last night for dinner, and Neil Patrick Harris and David Berger were there. We had like a nice little get together, and it's so funny. I was listening to John and Lizzie, and they're just a very funny couple. And I was saying, like, one day if you and I, say, wanted to go on vacation, John and Lizzie should host this show because they are the real life version of a talk show. I've never seen anything like it. Like, they can wax poetic about everything and anything. And if you mention a person, they have deep history with that person. Doesn't matter who it is. It's like they are just
6 degrees of Kevin Bacon.
They are the marital Kevin Bacon.
That's true. I get it.
Yeah, so, and then Mark Consuelos, my baby daddy, surprised me this morning by flying home early.
Come on now.
I know.
Kelly came out the room today smiling really good.
But it was one of those things I was like, I wish you had
told me because I haven't shaved my legs since the last I haven't shaved the legs since our last encounter, which was about a month ago.
Well, so. I'm sure yeah. shaved legs or not, he was happy to be.
Yeah, he was happy. He was okay. Didn't see. He pretended not to notice.
Now, here's the thing. This seems to be all anyone is talking about. Mm-hmm. Is, you know, it's never easy when people break up. You know, so it's not to be joked about or anything like
not.
That. But this is just ridiculous.
This is like a whole other level.
Y'all.
That's like.
This is ridiculous. First of all, it's not funny because a family is you know, going through whatever, you
and
know, bless
kids.
Them.
There's kids involved. Involved. There's
but also, involved. Jennifer Aniston is married. She ain't tripping.
Yeah, she's not.
Like, she's not thinking about this.
No,
I mean...
Not. She's married to Justin Theroux.
Yeah, baby, she built a bridge and got over it a long time ago. I'm certain.
Yeah.
I'm certain. So what else do we have?
The thing I'm really concerned about, besides the welfare of the children, because that is actually really the thing that matters.
Of course, of course.
However, they do have that winery, and what about the wine? That was like the second thought was like, what about all that wine? Who's gonna drink all that wine? Because I know people that like it.
You gonna buy it in the auction?
Maybe we can buy it in the auction.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. Well, all blessings to them. Good luck to them. Hope that everything goes well. But, you know, it's not our business.
They're saying the weird thing about it is when the announcement came down that they had, that there was this divorce filing, that the earth shook. Literally, there was an earthquake in California. So even Mother Nature weighed in. They said it was a 3.2 magnitude earthquake. So there you go. There's that.
Mother Nature was mad. She's like, dang it!
Yeah.
So here's the thing also. They say that this is why fidgeting is good medicine. Okay, so here's the thing. I shake my leg.
Yeah, me too.
You know what I'm saying?
Like,
and my mom is always like, Jussie, stop. Ever since I was a kid, stop shaking your leg. She'll be like, stop.
Yeah.
But guess what? It's good for your muscles.
Yes. I come from a long line of fidgeters. My mom's a fidgeter. I'm a fidgeter. I have fidgeters. We're all fidgeters.
You're fidgeting right now.
I know, but...
Shaking your leg.
I know, but that's because...
But they say that it's good for the muscles. You know, it's good for the muscles. It keeps you going. A new study finds that fidgeting...
Is it good for your metabolism, too, right?
Is it good for your metabolism?
They say it keeps your metabolism burning. So, everybody, you should be fidgeting. Like, go ahead. Go for it. Run that engine. Ladies, run the engine. Start your engines. Hi. Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Here's what else is interesting. I just want to go back to this for a second. They're saying that people who star in movies together tend to have marriages that don't work out. So we should not star in anything.
Yeah, we won't do that. We won't do
so
that.
So let's remember that.
God, I got you.
Because I love you more.
I got you. I love you more than
real,
this business.
Yeah, exactly.
But wait, have you and Mark ever worked together? I mean,
yeah,
I know that
we
you co-hosted,
met. We met working together. I screen tested him on all
you
my
You screen
shows.
Tested everybody. She's
yes.
OG.
It was.
Like, screen test everybody. She said yesterday she screen tested Terrence.
I did. No, there's. You'll be hard pressed to find an actor on this show that I have not screen tested. But you were a newborn baby when I had retired from acting. A slight age difference between us.
I mean, I really wanted to audition for Hope and Faith, but they had no roles for me.
Yeah.
So it's
you would have been a newborn. You would have been
good.
The newborn baby.
Oh, good.
But yeah, you know, so it's a very interesting thing because Mark and I've worked together quite a few times, and we enjoy it. I mean, I enjoy it. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he enjoys it. But they say it can really be a killer. Particularly if the movie is a flop. If the movie flops, so goes the marriage, is what they're saying in this article that nobody cares about.
I don't really know. The thing is, y'all worked together before.
Before
you were together.
Yes, that's right.
So even
as
if
a matter of fact, I believe the writers wrote us to together. I mean, we were working together, but we weren't playing love interests. We then became love interests, and then the writers wrote us as love interests. We then got married, and then they married us, and then we had kids, and then our characters had kids. And then I was like, I'm getting out of here before somebody dies tragically, and then they decide to kill us in real life.
But you know a lot of people, though, break up after they've worked together. Like, you look at, like, Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball. Mm. They were together all those years, mm-hmm. and then they broke up once the show was over.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's another thing. Maybe you should just work together forever so you can stay together.
Well, definitely, Gelman and I will break up when the show goes off.
No. Well, definitely.
No. Listen, I'm filing a restraining order preemptively.
Yeah, and after I'm done today, me and Art are done.
Done. We
like,
are
done. I don't want to see you again.
We're never going to see each other, at least not until the Christmas party. Yeah. Hey, anybody interested in buying the Harry Potter house where he was locked under the stairs? Yeah, remember that house? Do you guys remember 4 Privet Drive?
Yes.
That belonged to his aunt and uncle, the Dursleys, remember? It's for sale.
Bargain.
It's a bargain, yeah.
How much?
It's listed at $616,000.
That's not bad.
How many pounds is that, Gelman? Can you do the pound dollar ratio in your head?
400 and something thousand.
It comes with all the figgy pudding you can eat. I don't know why I say that so bad. Anyway, it's for sale, so that's exciting.
Yeah, sure. Listen, on today's show, we have Kiefer Sutherland. And the hilarious and talented Ken Jeong.
He is. Sneak peek at the season premiere of my co-host show Empire. Yeah. You better be in the sneak peek. If you're not in the sneak peek, I'm going to be enraged.
I got you.
Okay.
I hope so.
Okay, good. Wait, cover your...
Oh, yeah.
Is that water or vodka?
No, this is water.
Okay.
With vodka.
It's time for takeoff travel trivia, everybody.
Yesterday. You got a little bit on your teeth.
I have food on my teeth?
No. It's
lipstick?
A little bit of lipstick. You're good.
Oh, my
good.
Gosh. Thank you. You know what? You're...
We got to get off this plane. There's snakes on the plane.
Here's the mixed signal that they're trying to send us. Not only are we on the plane, but we're also guiding the plane into the hangar.
But no hands.
I say. Hey, today's trivia dancer is Annette Roberts from Wickenburg, Arizona.
Come on, Annette.
Were you a cheerleader? Were you a cheerleader? Were you a cheerleader?
I was a cheerleader.
I can tell. See that? That's cheerleader.
Cheer hands. Woo!
Cheer hands. Cheer hands. That means everybody make some noise.
Let me just take this right now off of hold.
Yeah. That's Kurt Johnson from Yakima, Washington. Hey, Kurt.
Hi, Kelly. Hi, Jesse.
Hey, Kurt. What's up?
Not much. Up early.
Up early. Oh, yeah.
Hey, that's a cool dog.
Yeah.
What kind of dog? What kind of dog? Zeus?
Yeah.
That's the perfect name for that dog.
Listen, should I ask the question now?
No, I gotta spin the wheel.
Oh, my bad.
I gotta spin the wheel. We're gonna see what you're playing for.
I'm new to this.
I forgot to talk to you about that. He did Andy Cohen's show last night. That's why he forgot that we spin the wheel before you.
Too much fun.
Mm-hmm. Full service bar.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah. Hey, listen, Kurt, you're playing for the Turnberry Isle in Miami.
Mm. Oh, okay.
Mm, seven days, six nights.
What does it include, Jesse?
It includes a spa treatment per person, a round of golf for two. This trip is provided by, in part by Hotels.com, and the value is $8,200. So put it on eBay and make some money.
Great idea. Hey, listen. Kurt, you have 20 seconds and only one guess. Good luck.
On yesterday's show, we talked with the great Jada Pinkett Smith. What did Jada say her son Jaden gave her for her birthday?
Gold grill.
Come on! Yes! I love it!
Congratulations. You and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at Turnberry Isle, Miami. Tucked away on 300 lush acres in Aventura, Florida, Turnberry Isle, Miami is a tropical oasis that exemplifies a culture of authenticity, spirited service, and enriching experiences. Enjoy spacious guest rooms and suites, 36 holes of championship golf, tennis, a wellness spa and fitness center, fine dining, and much more. Your prize is valued at approximately $8,200.
Hey, Kurt, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive 8 place settings of American-made fine china from Lennox. This prize usually goes to a man, so I'm very excited. So please pick a number between 1 and 229.
24.
Oh, that's so perfect, though. But also, speaking of 24, next is Kiefer Sutherland.
Still ahead on Live from the series Dr. Ken, Ken Jeong. And coming up next, Kiefer Sutherland.
We do match. We literally do match.
On tomorrow's show from the series Secrets and Lies, Juliette Lewis will be here.
Yeah. And NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
And Mark Consuelos is here. And I'm going to shave my legs. He's gone from saving the president as Jack Bauer on 24 to being the president on his new ABC series. Please welcome back to the show, Kiefer Sutherland.
Yeah. Go big or go.
I am also blind without my glasses.
No, I feel really bad. You know. I saw the hand at the last second. I thought she's trying to hit me.
No, it's okay.
But I can't
really
see without my glasses.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
I have to tell you this. My little brother, all throughout college, had two posters in his dorm room, and it was Malcolm X and Jack Bauer.
Awesome.
So cool.
True story.
No, and I'm
true story.
I am truly flattered by the company. So
Malcolm X and Jack Bauer.
Tell your brother, thank you.
Great people. Listen, 216 episodes of 24. We've seen them all, but you.
I have not, no.
Yeah, do you watch yourself? Because a lot of actors don't like to watch.
I can't. I have the benefit that I was actually there when they made them, so. but no, I when I was about 17 years old, I was at a cast and crew screening of one of the first films I'd ever made, and I was with my girlfriend at the time, and I remember at the end of the film leaning over to her because I was so unhappy with what I had done that I said, if I don't get another job before this comes out, it's over. And she said, no, I think you did really well. And I was like, don't patronize me. And,
oh, my gosh.
And I felt awful because the film came out and was
the
biggest...
What movie was it?
Stand By Me.
Oh come on!
And it was the biggest hit of the summer.
I've heard of that.
And so I realized at that point that maybe it was best I didn't watch the stuff, that I should just do the work, and so with 24 and really pretty much everything, except for maybe Flatliners, I have managed to navigate my way around.
Do you watch the rest of your family? Do you watch your daughter?
Oh my gosh,
dad?
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
I love your daughter. I'm her biggest fan. You know.
Oh, that's
she's
so, well. I'm her biggest fan, but I'll let you be her second.
I'm her second biggest. I'm her biggest fan that is not responsible for her actually being here.
Here. Okay.
Earth. Yeah.
Cool.
She's
cool.
Tremendous. And Veep won at the Emmys.
I think they've won. I think they've won every time they've been out there.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
She's an extraordinary actor. She gets mad at me when I talk about her publicly.
I'm sorry, I brought it up.
No, and
don't get mad at your father.
Well, and I'm gonna tell her that. But the truth is, she's worked so hard to do this on her own. I couldn't even tell you her agent's name. I would have no idea.
Wow.
There were two times, and this is actually a funny story. There were two times that I really needed a great young actress. One was a film with my dad, mm-hmm. Forsaken, and another was another smaller movie. And I asked her both times if she would really help me out and do these parts, and she respectfully declined because she didn't want the association. And I was like, no, you don't understand. I put you through college. I need your help right now. And she was like, yeah, sorry about that.
That's amazing.
But so I'm so proud of her because she really has done this all on her own.
She's done it well. Really respect her for it. She's exceptional.
She's got it in her blood, too.
She sure does.
Excellent. You're shooting this new show, Designated Survivor, in your hometown of Toronto.
In Toronto, yeah.
Are you seeing people that you knew from when you were younger?
Yeah, my mom, my sister.
Besides relatives.
There was actually a very funny story. I'd been playing some music over the summer, and I played a show up in Peterborough. And I met someone backstage and said, is it true that you were friends with Stephen Barker? And I was like, oh my God, no, this is my best friend of all time.
Yeah.
He was my best friend from the time I was 10 all the way till when I left Canada. And he and I started playing guitar together when we were kids. He was really important in my life. And he said, well, I think he's out in the audience. Well, the audience was about 15,000 people. And they were all sitting on this beautiful kind of manicured hill, grass hill. And I said in between one of the songs that I had heard Stephen Barker was out there, and if that's true, I'd really love to see you. And he stood up, and he was way at the back, and everybody started clapping. No one got in the way.
Wow.
And I saw him for the first time after 15 years from that night. And so...
Well, we have him here. Let's bring him out, everybody.
Just kidding.
That's how you scare Jack Bauer. Would have been amazing.
Shoot him 14 times. That's the life out of it.
When we come back, we'll find out what it means to be a designated survivor. That is designated survivor.
Went to commercial break and I leaned in and I said to you, I did not realize this was a real thing, real job.
Yeah.
Can you explain to us the premise of what the designated survivor is?
It's actually part of the Constitution, and anytime there is a gathering, a formal gathering of the government where all of the members of the government will be together, i.e. the State of the Union, they have to have one person, and the truth is they have two, that become designated survivors to protect the line of succession to the presidency. Now, I get it when the Constitution was written because the Capitol building was made out of wood. Mm-hmm. They had just gone through a Revolutionary War. So between an earthquake, a fire, loyalists to England setting the building on fire, I understand that. At the turn of the century, I think we really kind of kept up with it out of kind of respect for or reverence for our own history. But at the beginning of our show, the Capitol building is attacked, and my character, who was set aside to protect the line of succession, becomes president. But nowadays, I think it's kind of viewed, at least in the context of our show, as a punishment.
I see.
That if you're in the doghouse, they don't let you come to the ball and they make you become the designated survivor. So.
But how do they, do you know how they really choose? Is it just random? Is it everybody puts their name in the hat and then they...
You would hope that they put more thought into it than that.
I
would have thought that they would have naturally had chosen the vice president because that's what people elected if something were to happen to the president
right.
to happen. But I don't think anyone's ever taken it seriously for a very long time until our writer David Guggenheim decided to write this.
I wonder what would happen.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And so your character's speechwriter is played by Cal Penn, right?
Yes.
And wasn't he a speechwriter for
President Obama?
President Obama for a while, right?
He
got out of acting for a spell. And
for those of you who don't know, Cal Penn was a very successful actor, got involved with President Obama's campaign. The two of them became friendly, and President Obama asked him. He was doing a show called House.
Yeah.
And phoned him up and said, I know you've got a really great job right now, but would you consider coming to the White House and working for me for a few years? And Cal's response was, I'm taking it that this A isn't a joke, and B, I can't say no. And he said, no, you're right on both accounts.
Yeah.
And so Cal went to Washington for 2 years, well, 2.5, almost 3 years, and wrote speeches for the president and was very involved in that administration.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wow. Did you guys ask him questions, you know, just to see how real you're getting it? You know, do you look the president in the eye? Do you?
Nonstop.
Yeah.
In fact, we've asked him so many questions that he makes sure that he doesn't come out of his trailer till the last possible.
Oh, that's funny, yeah.
But the truth is, he's been a great source of information. So if I'm doing a scene where I'm walking, there's two offices that you get to before you get to the Oval Office. We had a scene and we had it blocked out, and we wanted to make it feel chaotic and given the circumstances of the show. And he said, under any circumstance, these people would not be allowed in here, and so we had to get rid of them. And so stuff like that, he keeps us honest.
But at a certain point, are you like, all right, Cal, enough?
I haven't hit that point yet.
But we get it, you worked for President Obama.
It's Designated Survivor. It debuts tonight at 10 p.m. on ABC. Love having you here.
Always a pleasure. God bless you.
There is in the house. Please welcome back to the show the very charming and very handsome Kim Jong.
That's all the time we have for the show.
I know.
We'll see you tomorrow, everyone.
Have a great weekend. Bye. I just got a phone number for
you. Yeah. Well, because you realize that 9 months from now, a baby shall be born. That goes without saying.
Yeah.
I mean, that's...
Wait, Ken, my friend, where did you pick up the move?
Well, I'm in my 40s, and I watch a lot of 80s MTV. Three moves just, like, beat it to death. So, you know, it's just variations. It's either, like, it's like that or whatever.
Okay.
Y'all got that. See, you can do it better than me. Yeah.
So we go, okay. I see you, Ken.
And then it's like that.
See you, Ken.
Like that, yeah. Okay, just two moves. Just two moves, yeah.
Does your wife dance like that?
No, she does not. but she's a better dancer. She's a classier dancer, does a little ballroom dancing. She's just classier than I will ever be.
Last time you were here, you were planning your first ever trip to Disney World.
Yes.
Did you wind up going?
Yeah, we ended up going. I went for the first time ever, my kids too, and we had a blast. Went to Epcot. It was a, oh yeah.
Aww.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Wait, that's not my kids.
Those were fans.
They were fans. Yeah, there they are. My wife, Tran, and on the left, Alexa, on the right, Zoe. Yep, that's her name. Yep.
Which one is the gymnast and which one is the actress?
Yes, Alexa is the gymnast, and she does a lot of junior competitions across the state of California, and she just, like, placed third overall in her region.
Oh, my gosh.
Like, man, Alexa. Go for Alexa.
And Zoe is the actress of the family, so
Oh my gosh.
She guest starred on a couple episodes of Dr. Ken.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's coming
up. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, yeah. She plays my TV son Stalker on the show. In an episode coming up in 2 weeks, basically I wrote a part for her where like literally she just stares through a window.
Oh my god!
Like the whole episode.
That's incredible. Yeah. Oh, I love that. Now, was she difficult to work with? Were you like, don't make me recast you?
She was really easy. I mean, it was really nice to work with family and to work with. She's got more natural talent than me, so it was very. She just kind of locked in, knew what to do. She had no lines. She couldn't screw up, so she had zero lines.
Sometimes that's the hardest job of all.
You know what? You're right. As an actor, I mean, even what Michael Caine always said, like the one-line roles are the hardest. Absolutely. So.
But you got us all excited though recently because you posted a Hangover poster on Instagram. You did. Is there news that you want to break?
No. That was a fan poster that someone like tweeted or Instagrammed to me, and I just kind of reposted that. It just honestly just brought back great memories, and I had to.
It's a great idea though.
Oh, no, yeah.
There should be one. Think about it. You put it out in the universe, and we all got excited, and we all want to go see the movie, so you guys should probably make another movie.
Drama.
Look, when we come back, we'll talk about big changes for Dr. Ken.
Oh, my gosh.
Enter Live's Cats the Cat. Tune in to win for the chance to win Cats Pride Fresh and Light products at $10,000. Cats Pride Fresh and Light is the best performing lightweight litter. Enter now at livekelly.com or our Facebook page.
Next live, Mark Consuelos from Pitch.
My baby daddy's on co-host duty.
It's Juliet Lewis and...
Can someone shut the door?
Will Dr. Ken be working with his wife?
Dr. Ken will be working with his wife, and that's based on my real life wife, who's also a doctor, and we met at the same HMO where we worked in California. So this season's going to be even more true to life, and it's really cool to have that dynamic in the workplace of, two doctors working at the same HMO and then also living together at home. It's just it's a whole different dynamic this year.
You shouldn't make a movie about that because it could be a disaster for you. There was a study about it in the newspaper today.
It was really today?
Well, by a study, I mean there was an article written, and I call every article a study. Which is a bad habit I've developed.
Right.
Bad habit.
Managing editor says, it's bad.
How closely does your life and Dr. Ken's how close are they related?
Will
Dr. Ken become an actor?
that's a great question. We're always teasing that a little bit, like in the season finale last year, my character did stand-up comedy, and that was based on my real life, like where I used to do stand-up comedy on the side before I became an actor while I was still working as a doctor. So, but I think in many ways this show is kind of like an alternate kind of the universe, like what would happen if the Hangover had never happened.
Right.
So to me, like, this would be my life. I do love, my character loves comedy, I do love comedy, but I love my family first and foremost. And I think that's what this show really reflects, is like, this would have been my life if I had never like ventured into acting. So
you are the most useful actor in the history of actors.
Truly.
You do realize that.
Truly, yeah.
But he's still
so
practicing.
Great. Yeah. Really?
He still has his medical license. He realized that if I started choking, he could fix it.
I could call the guy. I really could call the guy. Yep.
I mean, that's I love it. Will you be doing more stand-up on the show? Will Dr. Ken?
Well, we teased it a little bit in the third episode where Ken does an HMO. He always performs every year at this physician's banquet. Mm. And this year, he gets passed over for hosting it in favor of Dave Foley. And his feelings get hurt because he just crushed it at the legendary Laugh Factory in front of friends and family, and he gets passed over. So you're always teasing a little bit of that. It's a lot of fun.
Listen, we have to, will you play a quick game with us?
Sure.
We'd like to play a quick game with you called the Impression Session.
That's right.
Are you game for that?
I'm game for that.
Okay, when we come back, that's what we're going to do. We're going to play Impression Session. Some fun with an impression session. So there are names of very famous people in this fishbowl. Hey, this fishbowl right here. And we're all gonna take turns doing our best impressions. Ken, since you're our guest, you get to go first, and then Jesse and I will try to top you.
Okay.
So pick away.
Pick away.
Okay.
I pity the fool who don't respect my suit.
Mr. T!
Yeah, that was good. Your turn. Oh boy. Okay. Yep.
I want to sing a song for you. Hello.
Oh, Adele.
There you go.
Yeah. Ah. Hello. I was gonna say Lionel
you
Richie.
Had me.
I know.
You had me at hello. Yeah. I just showed it to you.
So I didn't see it, I swear.
Okay.
Start me up!
Oh, Mick Jagger. I mean, or a rented Volvo. I'm not sure.
You want to do another one?
Yeah, okay.
Let's see.
This is amazing. We can all agree we're incredible.
Okay. Yeah, definitely.
All right. Anyway, you ready for this? I'm out of control. Anyway.
Outrageous.
Yeah. Right. Oh, that's good.
That's good.
That's really good.
That is good. That is good. That was like scary. I'm getting a chill.
I know a little bit of deja vu. Anyway.
Okay.
Oh. Mm. Michelle and
Barack Obama.
How did you get that?
Amazing.
Wait, how did you get that?
I just.
You just said the word Michelle.
I just locked
it.
That's
it. But I said.
Michelle. That was really good.
Okay. I love this. Uh-oh, Sherry.
Oh, Scooby-Doo. Scooby-Doo?
Mick Jagger. No.
Mick Jagger. Rocky Rock.
Scooby-Doo.
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 Yeah. Scooby-Doo and Mick Jagger.
Scooby-Doo and Mick Jagger.
If they had a puppet. Should we do one more? One more? Okay.
All right. It's just ludicrous. I'm not really...
Mike Tyson.
Mm-hmm. Yep. We're on the same page.
Okay. We're right here. We're
right here.
Let's see.
Mike, I don't think that sounds like you at all. Just in case he's watching.
I don't know how to do this.
Mick Jagger. No.
I have to skip.
Okay.
It was Johnny Carson.
Oh.
Yeah.
Man, I'm Lucius Lyon.
Darren Tower. I know. Okay.
No.
Beyonce all on his mouth.
Beyonce!
Beyonce. You need a fan to do a Beyonce impersonation.
Come on, y'all. The
I
new
can't
season.
My Sorry.
Y'all, the new season of Dr. Ken premieres on Friday at 8:30 on ABC. Do not miss it.
Good job, everybody.
If you'd like to know more about anything you see online, just log on to our website at livekelly.com.
That's a good one.
going to be a good one. It's really good.
Oh, that's Empire. The season premiere is tonight at 9 on Fox. What can we expect this season? What are we going to see?
Just watch first 4 minutes.
Someone drops off the roof.
No, no.
You will find all in the first 4 minutes tonight.
Seriously?
Empire Wednesday.
What? I mean, do you mean it?
No, I swear.
Okay. Like,
somebody's going to drop.
Oh.
Boom.
Oh, my God. Oh. So, anyway, okay, all right. I want to thank you. You were incredible.
Course,
make sure you check it out tonight, Empire. Tonight, everybody. Tomorrow. Who's going to drink all that wine? Because I know people that like it.
You going to buy it in the auction?
Maybe we can buy it in the auction.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. Well, all blessings to them. Good luck to them. Hope that everything goes well. But, you know, it's not our business.
They're saying the weird thing about it is when they when the announcement came down that they had that there was this divorce filing, that the earth shook. Literally, there was an earthquake in California. So even Mother Nature weighed in. They said it was a 3.2 magnitude earthquake. So there you go. There's that.
Mother Nature was mad. She's like, dang it!
Yeah.
So here's the thing also. They say that this is why fidgeting is good medicine. Okay, so here's the thing. I shake my leg.
Yeah, me too.
You know what I'm saying?
My leg shaking.
And my mom is always like, Jussie, stop. Ever since I was a kid, stop shaking your leg. She'll be like, stop.
Yeah.
But guess what? It's good for your muscles.
Yes. I come from a long line of fidgeters. My mom's a fidgeter. I'm a fidgeter. I have fidgeters. We're all fidgeters.
You're fidgeting right now.
I know, but.
Shaking your leg.
I know, but that's because.
But they say that it's good for the muscles. You know, it's good for the muscles. It keeps you going. A new study finds that fidgeting.
Too, right?
Is it good for your metabolism?
They say it keeps your metabolism burning. So everybody, you should be fidgeting. Like, go ahead, go for it. Run that engine. Ladies, run the engine. Start your engines. Hi. Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Here's what else is interesting. I just want to go back to this for a second. They're saying that people who star in movies together tend to have marriages that don't work out. So we should not star in anything.
Yeah, we won't do that. We won't do
so
that.
So let's remember that.
God, I got you.
Because I love you more.
I got you. I love you more than
real,
this business.
Yeah, exactly.
But wait, have you and Mark ever worked together? I mean,
yeah,
I know that
we
you
met. We met working together. I screen tested him on all
you
my.
You screen tested everybody. She's
yes.
OG.
It was
like, screen test everybody. She said yesterday she screen tested Terrence.
I did. No, there's. You'll be hard pressed to find an actor on this show that I have not screen tested. But you were a newborn baby when I had retired from acting. There's a slight age difference between us.
I mean, I really wanted to audition for Hope and Faith, but they had no roles for me.
Yeah.
You would have been the newborn baby. Oh, good.
So it's a very interesting thing because Mark and I have worked together quite a few times, and we enjoy it. I mean, I enjoy it. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he enjoys it. But they say it can really be a killer. Particularly if the movie is a flop. If the movie flops, so goes the marriage, is what they're saying in this article that nobody cares about.
I don't really know. The thing is, y'all worked together before.
Before
you were together.
Yes, that's right.
So even
as a matter of fact, I believe the writers wrote us to. I mean, we were working together, but we weren't playing love interests. We then became love interests, and then the writers wrote us as love interests. We then got married, and then they married us, and then we had kids, and then our characters had kids. And then I was like, I'm getting out of here before somebody dies tragically, and then they decide to kill us in real life.
But you know a lot of people, though, break up after they've worked together. Like, you look at, like, Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball. Mm. They were together all those years, mm-hmm. and then they broke up once the show was over.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's another thing. Maybe you should just work together forever so you can stay together.
Well, definitely Gelman and I will break up when the show goes off.
Well, definitely.
I'm filing a restraining order preemptively.
Yeah, and after I'm done today, me and Art are done.
We are done.
I don't want to see you again.
We're never going to see each other, at least not until the Christmas party. Yeah. Hey,
Anybody interested in buying the Harry Potter house where he was locked under the stairs? Yeah, remember that house? Do you guys remember 4 Privet Drive?
Yes.
That belonged to his aunt and uncle, the Dursleys, remember? It's for sale.
Bargain.
It's a bargain, yeah.
How much?
It's listed at $616,000.
That's not bad.
How many pounds is that, Gelman? Can you do the pound-dollar ratio in your head?
400 and something thousand.
It comes with all the figgy pudding you can eat. I don't know why I say that. So bad. Anyway, it's for sale, so that's exciting.
Yeah, sure. Listen, on today's show, we have Kiefer Sutherland. And the hilarious and talented Ken Jeong.
He is. Sneak peek at the season premiere of my co-host show Empire. Yeah. You better be in the sneak peek.
If you're not
in the sneak peek, I'm going to be enraged.
I got you.
Okay.
I hope so.
Okay, good. Wait, cover your...
Oh, yeah.
Is that water or vodka?
No, this is water.
Okay.
With vodka.
It's time for takeoff travel trivia, everybody.
Yesterday.
You got a little bit on your feet.
I have food on my teeth?
No. It's
lipstick?
A little bit of lipstick. You good.
Oh, my
good.
Gosh. Thank you. You know what?
We got to get off this plane. There's snakes on the plane.
Here's the mixed signal that they're trying to send us. Not only are we on the plane, but we're all... She's cool. Tremendous. And Veep won at the Emmys.
I think they've won every time they've been out there.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
She's an extraordinary actor. She gets mad at me when I talk about her publicly.
Sorry, I brought it up.
No, and
don't get mad at your phone.
Well, and I'm gonna tell her that. But the truth is, she's worked so hard to do this on her own. I couldn't even tell you her agent's name. I would have no idea.
Wow.
There were two times, and this is actually a funny story. There were two times that I really needed a great young actress. One was a film with my dad, mm-hmm. Forsaken, and another was another smaller movie. And I asked her both times if she would really help me out and do these parts, and she respectfully declined because she didn't want the association. And I was like, no, you don't understand. I put you through college. I need your help right now. And she was like, yeah, sorry about that.
That's amazing.
But so I'm so proud of her because she really has done this all on her own.
She's done it well, really respect her for it. She's exceptional.
She's got it in her blood, too.
She sure
it's
does.
Excellent. Excellent. You come from, you're shooting this new show, Designated Survivor, yeah. In your hometown of Toronto.
In
right?
Toronto, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you seeing people that you knew from when you were younger?
Yeah, my mom, my sister.
Besides relatives.
There was actually a very funny story. I'd been playing some music over the summer, and I played a show up in Peterborough. And I met someone backstage and said, is it true that you were friends with Stephen Barker? And I was like, oh my God, no, this is my best friend of all time.
Yeah.
He was my best friend from the time I was 10 all the way till when I left Canada. And he and I started playing guitar together when we were kids. He was really important in my life. And he said, well, I think he's out in the audience. Well, the audience was about 15,000 people. And they were all sitting on this beautiful kind of manicured hill, grass hill. And I said in between one of the songs that I had heard Stephen Barker was out there, and if that's true, I'd really love to see you. And he stood up, and he was way at the back, and everybody started clapping. No one got in the way.
Wow.
And I saw him for the first time after 15 years from that night. And so...
Well, we have him here. Let's bring him out, everybody.
You don't really
know. Just kidding.
That's how you scare Jack
Bauer.
That would
have been amazing.
Yeah.
Would have been amazing.
Shoot him 14 times. That scared the life out of him.
When we come back, we'll find out what it means to be a designated survivor.
Survivor.
Sort of went to commercial break, and I leaned in, and I said to you, I did not realize this was a real thing, real job. Yeah. Can you explain to us the premise of what the designated survivor is?
It's actually part of the Constitution, and anytime there is a gathering, formal gathering of the government, where all of the members of the government will be together, i.e. the State of the Union, they have to have one person, and the truth is they have two, that become designated survivors to protect the line of succession to the presidency. Now, I get it when the Constitution was written because the Capitol building was made out of wood. Mm-hmm. They had just gone through a Revolutionary War. So between an earthquake, a fire, loyalists to England setting the building on fire, I understand that. At the turn of the century, I think we really kind of kept up with it out of kind of respect for or reverence for our own history. But at the beginning of our show, the Capitol building is attacked, and my character, who was set aside to protect the line of succession, becomes president. But nowadays, I think it's kind of viewed, at least in the context of our show, as a punishment.
I see.
That if you're in the doghouse, they don't let you come to the ball, and they make you become the designated survivor. So,
but how do they, do you know how they really choose? Is it just random? Is it everybody puts their name in the hat and then they...
You would hope that they put more thought into it than that. I would have thought that they would have naturally had chosen the vice president because that's what people elected if something were to happen to the president to happen. But I don't think anyone's ever taken it seriously for a very long time until our writer David Guggenheim decided to write this.
I wonder what would happen. Wow. That's amazing. And so your character's speechwriter is played by Cal Penn, right?
Yes.
And wasn't he a speechwriter for
President Obama?
President Obama for a while, right?
He
got out of acting for a spell. And
for those of you who don't know, Cal Penn was a very successful actor, got involved with President Obama's campaign. The two of them became friendly, and President Obama asked him, he was doing a show called House, and phoned him up and said, I know you've got a really great job right now, but would you consider coming to the White House and working for me for a few years? And Cal's response was, I'm taking it that this A isn't a joke, and B, I can't say no. And he said, no, you're right on both accounts.
Yeah.
And so Cal went to Washington for 2 years, well, 2.5, almost 3 years, and wrote speeches for the president and was very involved in that administration.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wow. Did you guys ask him questions, you know, just to see how real you're getting it? You know, do you look the president in the eye? Do you?
Nonstop.
Yeah.
In fact, we've asked him so many questions that he makes sure that he doesn't come out of his trailer to the last possible.
Oh, that's funny, yeah.
But the truth is, he's been a great source of information. So if I'm doing a scene where I'm walking, there's two offices that you get to before you get to the Oval Office. We had a scene and we had it blocked out, and we wanted to make it feel chaotic and given the circumstances of the show. And he said, under any circumstance, these people would not be allowed in here, and so we had to get rid of them. And so stuff like that, he keeps us honest.
But at a certain point, are you like, all right, Cal, enough?
I haven't hit that point yet.
Like, we get it, you worked for President Obama.
Listen, I'm so excited about this new show. Congratulations, it's designated.
Jussie Smollett.
You know what it is? It's Empire Wednesday! The season premieres tonight.
I've heard of that show.
Yeah, a couple times.
Are you excited?
I'm excited.
I haven't seen it yet. You don't get to see in advance?
I do, but I don't want to. I want to see it with the people. You know what I'm saying? I saw the first four. The first 4 minutes, man, it's heavy. But we find out who
you know. So yeah, first 4 minutes, you don't want to miss it. You don't
want to
miss it. You don't want to miss it.
And then I'm so excited.
I'll be live tweeting tonight like crazy.
Oh, okay. So is that part of it? You live tweet?
I mean, it's not like a contractual obligation.
No, but people are very engaged in that right now.
Yeah, yeah.
That's like all part of.
I think that kind of started with like Scandal, you know, because they really were so great at social media. I think that we all kind of took a clue from them.
Yeah, we started live tweeting here about 7 years after Twitter started. Mm-hmm. And by live tweeting, I mean we would tweet something that happened on the live show about 3.5 weeks later.
I mean, hey, sometimes you got it happens.
Yeah, that's
like
how
that.
we're at the tail end of social media, but we're getting there.
We're getting there.
We're working on it every day. There's fresh hope. Every day, there's fresh hope.
We could do it. We could do it. Y'all.
So is there something else going on in your life?
There is. There is a big announcement today. November 25th of this year. I'm nervous to even say it out loud.
Guys, just sit on your hands for a second.
November 25th of this year, one night only, I will be opening in Hawaii with the great Mariah Carey. Tickets go on sale this Saturday, so come one, come all.
Guys, it's so easy to get to from here.
Just go chill in LA.
But you said you've never been to Hawaii.
I've never been to Hawaii.
We've done the show in Hawaii.
See?
It is.
You should come and do the show in Hawaii during Thanksgiving.
Done and done. Did you hear the good news, Gelman? We're doing the show in Hawaii during Thanksgiving, nice. And we're going to live broadcast and tweet Jussie opening for Mariah.
That's right. Wow. That's right. The Sweet Sweet Fantasy Tour is coming to Hawaii. Yeah.
Very exciting.
So it's exciting. Very it's my first time being on a tour. It's my first time opening for anybody. So it's the great Mariah Carey. So don't get better than that.
I'm jittery. I'm so excited.
I'm jittery because I'm nervous.
I mean, I'm jittery and I'm nervous and I'm excited and you've never been to Hawaii and it's so gorgeous. I'm afraid you may not come back. They may have to move Empire to Hawaii.
Oh my God. You know what? We don't travel enough on Empire.
No.
We don't. That's actually very true. We'll make it happen.
Cookie goes to Hawaii.
So how was your night?
I had a great night. I went to my friend John and Lizzie Tisch's house last night for dinner, and Neil Patrick Harris and David Berger were there. We had like a nice little get together, and it's so funny. I was listening to John and Lizzie, and they're just a very funny couple. And I was saying, like, one day if you and I, say, wanted to go on vacation, John and Lizzie should host this show because they are the real life version of a talk show. I've never seen anything like it. Like, they can wax poetic about everything and anything. And if you mention a person, they have deep history with that person. Doesn't matter who it is. It's like they are just
6 degrees of Kevin Bacon.
They are the marital Kevin Bacon.
That's true. I get it.
Yeah, so, and then Mark Consuelos, my baby daddy, surprised me this morning by flying home early.
Come on now.
I know.
Kelly came out the room today smiling really good.
But it was one of those things I was like, I wish you had told me because I haven't shaved my legs since the last I haven't shaved the legs since our last encounter, which was about a month ago.
Well, so. I'm sure shaved legs or not, he was happy to be
there. Yeah, he was happy. He pretended not to notice.
Now, here's the thing. This seems to be all anyone is talking about is, you know, it's never easy when people break up, you know, so it's not to be joked about or anything
this.
But this is just ridiculous.
This is like a whole other level.
Y'all.
That's like...
This is ridiculous. First of all, it's not funny because a family is you know, going through whatever, you know, bless them.
There's kids involved.
But also, Jennifer Aniston is married. She ain't tripping.
Yeah, she's not.
Like, she's not thinking about this.
No,
I mean,
not. She's married to Justin Theroux.
Yeah, baby, she built a bridge and got over it a long time ago. I'm certain.
Yeah.
I'm certain. So what else do we have?
The thing I'm really concerned about, besides the welfare of the children, because that is actually really the thing that matters.
Of course.
However, they do have that winery, and what about the wine? The second thought was like, what about all that wine? Also guiding the plane into the hangar.
But no hands.
I say. Hey, today's trivia dancer is Annette Roberts from Wickenburg, Arizona. Were you a cheerleader?
I was a cheerleader.
I can tell. See that? That's cheerleader.
Cheer hands. Woo!
Cheer hands. Cheer hands. That means everybody make some noise.
Let me just take this right now off of hold.
Yeah. That's Kurt Johnson from Yakima, Washington. Hey, Kurt.
Hi, Kelly. Hi, Jesse.
Hey, Kurt. What's up?
Not much. Up early.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, that's a cool dog.
Yeah.
What kind of dog? Zeus?
Yeah.
That's the perfect name for that dog.
Listen, should I ask the question now?
No, I gotta spin the wheel.
Oh, my bad.
I gotta spin the wheel. We're gonna see what you're playing for. To talk to you about that. He did Andy Cohen's show last night. That's why he forgot that we spin the wheel before you.
Too much fun.
Mm-hmm. Full service bar.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah. Hey, listen, Kurt, you're playing for the Turnberry Isle in Miami.
Seven days, six nights.
What does it include, Jesse?
It includes a spa treatment per person, a round of golf for two. This trip is provided in part by Hotels.com, and the value is $8,200. So put it on eBay and make some money.
Great idea. Hey, listen. Kurt, you have 20 seconds and only one guess. Good luck.
On yesterday's show, we talked with the great Jada Pinkett Smith. What did Jada say her son Jaden gave her for her birthday?
Gold grill.
Come on! Yes! I love it!
Congratulations, you and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at Turnberry Isle, Miami. Tucked away on 300 lush acres in Aventura, Florida, Turnberry Isle, Miami is a tropical oasis that exemplifies a culture of authenticity, spirited service, and enriching experiences. Enjoy spacious guest rooms and suites, 36 holes of championship golf, tennis, a wellness spa and fitness center, fine dining, and much more. Your prize is valued at approximately $8,200.
Hey, Kurt, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive 8 place settings of American-made fine china from Lennox. This prize usually goes to a man, so I'm very excited. So please pick a number between 1 and 229.
24.
Oh, that's so perfect, though. But also, speaking of 24, next is Kiefer Sutherland.
Still ahead on Live from the series Dr. Ken Jeong. And coming up next, Kiefer Sutherland.
We do match. We literally do match.
On tomorrow's show from the series Secrets and Lies, Juliette Lewis will be here.
Yeah. And NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
And Mark Consuelos is here. And I'm going to shave my legs. He's gone from saving the president as Jack Bauer on 24 to being the president on his new ABC series. Please welcome back to the show, Kiefer Sutherland.
Yeah. Go big or go.
funny. I am also blind without my glasses.
Well, no, I feel really bad. No. I saw the hand at the last second. I thought she's trying to hit me.
No, it's okay.
But I can't
really
see without my glasses.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
I have to tell you this. My little brother, all throughout college, had two posters in his dorm room, and it was Malcolm X and Jack Bauer.
Awesome.
So cool.
True story.
No, and I'm
true story.
I am truly flattered by the company. So
Malcolm X and Jack Bauer.
Tell your brother, thank you.
Great people. Listen, 216 episodes of 24. Mm. We've seen them all, but you have.
I have not, no.
Yeah, do you watch yourself? Because a lot of actors don't like to watch.
I can't. I have the benefit that I was actually there when they made them, so. but no, I when I was about 17 years old, I was at a cast and crew screening of one of the first films I'd ever made, and I was with my girlfriend at the time, and I remember at the end of the film leaning over to her because I was so unhappy with what I had done that I said, if I don't get another job before this comes out, it's over. And she said, no, I think you did really well. And I was like, don't patronize me. And,
oh, my gosh.
And I felt awful because the film came out and was
what
the biggest
was it?
Stand By Me.
Oh come on.
And it was the biggest hit of the summer.
I've heard of that.
And so I realized at that point that maybe it was best I didn't watch
yourself.
The stuff that I should just do the work and so with 24 and really pretty much everything, except for maybe Flatliners, I have managed to navigate my way around.
Do you watch the rest of your family? Do you watch your dog?
Oh my gosh,
dad?
Yeah,
of course.
Yeah.
I love your dog. I'm her biggest fan. You know.
Oh, that's
she's
so, well. I'm her biggest fan, but I'll let you be her second.
I'm her second biggest. I'm her biggest fan that is not responsible for her actually being here.
Here. Okay.
Earth. Yeah.
Cool.
Designated Survivor. It debuts tonight at 10 p.m. on ABC.
In the house, please welcome back to the show the very charming and very handsome Kim Jong.
That's all the time we have for the show.
I know.
We'll see you tomorrow, everyone.
Have a great weekend. Bye. I just got a phone number for
you. Yeah. Well, because you realize that 9 months from now, a baby shall be born. That goes without saying.
Yeah.
I mean, that's...
Wait, Ken, my friend, where did you pick up the mood?
Well, I'm in my 40s, and I watch a lot of 80s MTV. Three moves, just like beat it to death. So, you know, it's just variations. It's like that or whatever.
Okay.
Y'all got that. See, you can do it better than me. Yeah.
So we go, okay. I see you, Ken.
And then it's like that.
Okay. See? I see you, Ken.
Like that, yeah.
Okay, just two moves, yeah.
Does your wife dance like that?
No, she does not. but she's a better dancer. She's a classier dancer, does a little ballroom dancing. She's just classier than I will ever be.
Last time you were here, you were planning your first ever trip to Disney World.
Yes.
Did you wind up going?
Yeah, we ended up going. I went for the first time ever, my kids too, and we had a blast. Went to Epcot. It was a
amazing.
Wait, that's not my kids.
Those were fans.
They were fans. Yeah. So. Yeah, there they are. My wife, Tran, and on the left, Alexa, on the right, Zoe. Yep, that's her name.
Yep. Which one is the gymnast and which one is the actress?
Yes, Alexa is the gymnast, and she does a lot of junior competitions across the state of California, and she just, like, placed third overall in her region.
Oh, my God.
Like, man, Alexa, over there, Alexa. Ghost, ghost for Alexa. And Zoe is the actress of the family, so
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, she guest starred on a couple episodes of Dr. Ken.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's coming up.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, yeah. This, she plays my TV son's stalker on the show. In an episode coming up in 2 weeks, basically, I wrote a part for her where, like, literally she just stares through a window.
Oh, my God.
Like, the whole episode.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. Now, was she difficult to work with? Were you like, don't make me recast you?
She was really easy. I mean, it was really nice to work with family and to work with, she's got more natural talent than me, so it was very, she just kind of locked in, knew what to do. She had no lines. She couldn't screw up, so she had zero lines.
Sometimes that's the hardest job of all.
You know what? You're right. As an actor, I mean, even what Michael Caine always said, like, the one-line roles are the hardest. Absolutely. So.
But you got us all excited, though, recently, because you posted a Hangover poster on Instagram. You did. Is there news that you want to break?
No, that was a fan poster that someone, like, tweeted or Instagrammed to me, and I just kind of reposted that. It just honestly just brought back great memories, and I had to.
It's a great idea, though.
Oh, no, yeah.
There should be one. Think about you put it out in the universe, and we all got excited, and we all want to go see the movie, so you guys should probably make another movie.
Look, when we come back, we'll talk about big changes for Dr. Ken.
Oh, my gosh.
Enter Live's Cats the Cat Tune In to Win for the chance to win Cats Pride Fresh and Light products at $10,000. Cats Pride Fresh and Light is the best performing lightweight litter. Enter now at livekelly.com or our Facebook page.
Next live, Mark Consuelos from Pitch.
My baby daddy's on co-host duty.
Next, Juliet Lewis and...
Can someone shut the door?
Will Dr. Ken be working with his wife?
Dr. Ken will be working with his wife, and that's based on my real life wife, who's also a doctor, and we met at the same HMO where we worked in California. So this season's going to be even more true to life, and it's really cool to have that dynamic in the workplace of, two doctors working at the same HMO and then also living together at home. It's just a whole different dynamic.